This is another edition of KHL Faces. This time we're visiting Dynamo Moscow and we're going to talk about Leo Komarov. Leo, how do you say let's go in Russian?
Скажи поехали.
Поехали.
It's impossible to confuse him with anybody else. He's one of the kind. He has his own temper, he plays his own hockey, he does what he likes out there. He plays for Dynamo Moscow, a club who doesn't like their players to stand out, but he's the one who does. Every KHL defenseman knows Leo, and every KHL coach has nightmares about him. What can I say? It's Leo. Nobody likes to play against him, but everybody loves having him on their team, says Dynamo's defenseman Dominik Graniak. I played a few times against him on a national level. I know what I'm talking about. He's really hard to play against. Let me be honest with you. We're all really happy here he plays for Dynamo. Alright, let's get the basics out of the way. He cherishes four countries in his heart. He was born in Estonia, grew up in Finland, dreamt of playing in Canada, but truly found his game in his historic homeland, Russia. He played 210 games in the KHL for Dynamo and scored 110 points. 18 in 37 playoff games. He signed with Dynamo till April 2015 and he's one of seven KHL players who's free of the luxury tax. None of that could have happened if it wasn't for luck and a wise coach. When I was 18 years old, it was time for me to get a spot on a pro team, says Leo. And there wasn't a spot for me. I didn't play great in my junior career. But a few guys from the pro team got injured and I got called up. And that's when the coach told me to change my game around a little bit. So I started hitting people. Leo always went under the radar. He was never called up to play for the under-18s team. He was never a top goal scorer, stick handler, shooter, or any of that sort. Truth be told, he wasn't and still isn't the best when it comes to that. But have no doubt, Komarov is a key player for Dynamo Moscow and Team Finland. Every player on the team is important. It doesn't matter if you play 5 or 20 minutes, because in every shift something happens. A puck gets deflected, somebody finishes or doesn't finish the check, or a goalie can make a fantastic save. All of these bits and pieces are very important to the game. Final 2012 Gagarin Cup Finals. Dynamo is trailing to Avangard in the series 3-0. Every game can be the last one for Dynamo. Leo Komarov is the biggest pest on the ice. He always seems to be able to get Dynamo key power plays. Here's something even Avangard fans can surely agree on. If it wasn't for Leo, Avangard would have won the cup that year. When I put on my jersey, it's my business suit. I'm going to work, and they pay me real good money for it too. I'm like everybody else. I go to work and I prove every day that I deserve to have the job, that I'm qualified enough to be there. And then I just work for 2 hours. I look very different on the ice. Sometimes I don't even recognize myself out there. It's just a game though, no hard feelings. My opponents get really upset with me. Everybody is so angry at me. I don't get it. I don't think I do something special out there. My job is to help my team win, and that's exactly what I do. If I need to hit someone, I'll hit him. No regrets. I think that's the way our opponents feel about us, too. It's hockey. That's the way it works. Everybody wants to win. Anything can happen.
Blah!
Шутка Гагарина!
And then there was the flight back home. They had the Gagarin Cup on board along with cases of beer. There was no stopping to that party, and Leo was right in the thick of it. Honestly, I think everybody had maybe two beers max in the dressing room there. It looks like we were drunk out of our skulls, but actually it was just a very emotional win for us. We were just blowing off steam, getting it out from our system. It was awesome. You go through the playoffs and you forget every win as you go. You can watch it later on YouTube or DVD, but it just never comes back to you. I won a gold medal at the World Championship and a Gagarin Cup. I can't remember who I played against, but that's the extension of it. I can't recall any details at all. After winning two Gagarin Cups in a row, Dynamo Moscow became an example of a perfect team. A team where everyone is for one another. A team where everyone is watching everyone's back. And a team you don't want to mess with. They will do everything, everything, to get a W. It's always a team that wins. A team, not individuals, not star players, but a team. It's built by a coaching staff, and the most important time of the season is the playoffs. These are the few months when you need to be at your best. Teflon Leo, that's what they call him in Dynamo. He can take any player and endure multiple overtimes. He has a multi-million contract and has a right to drive to Baza on a rented Renault Logan. He doesn't care about this though. All he cares about is a team. Off the ice, I'm a really quiet guy. Before the game, my thoughts can be miles away from the rink. I can just sit there and listen to the music. Hockey is not everything my life is about. On a game day, I focus on hockey at the morning skating and at the game itself. Hockey takes just a few hours of my life a day, and then I just forget about it. You shouldn't think about hockey all the time, that's no way to live. Obviously, I can't say that for everyone else, but that's the way I feel. On Dynamo, Komarov is the best NHL 14 player and also a king at the card table. He's always ready to play, drills don't wear him down. I like our practices. They make you feel like a robot. You know that the practice begins at 11 a.m. You go out there and you know your entire drill schedule. It's always the same. It's something you get used to and you don't get tired at all. He's Finnish, but he's also very much Russian. Local fans don't even think of him as a foreigner. It's easy to explain. He was born and raised in a Russian family, and yet he is Finnish. When I go home, I go to Finland. It's not like I'm saying Finland is better than Russia. It's just that I feel more comfortable there. I haven't lived in Russia much. I like what I've seen, though. I like it over here in Russia. But I call Finland my home. I grew up there. You can't change that. Leo Komarov is a mix of Russian blood and Finnish lifestyle. In Finland, they consider him their Russian. In Dynamo, they call him their Finn. He says the only people who can make him mad are the refs, and yet he's capable of making mad entire arena single-handedly. When I was a kid, sometimes I was getting in trouble, but it's all in the past. I never cross the line these days. His name made it to Gagarin Cup ring twice. He wouldn't mind getting his name engraved there once again, but Dynamo lost to Lokomotiv in Game 7 of the first round and got eliminated, finishing an otherwise outstanding season for Komarov. He was tied for first in scoring on Dynamo in the regular season and led the team in points in the playoffs as well. Playoffs has always been his favorite time. He played so many playoff games that don't make him nervous anymore. To him, the thing that is different the most in the playoffs is that the games are played in the springtime and it's sunny outside when he gets to the ring. That's the time when he really gets under his opponent's skin. My routine in the playoffs is pretty much identical to the regular season. Except maybe they can make you sleep over at the buzzer a few times. Maybe I start thinking about hockey a little more during the playoffs too. You feel the biggest pressure when you're waiting for the games, not when you're actually on the ice taking part in them. I mean, you think about the game a little more before and after it happens, but out there you feel like it's just another game. Leo Komarov, a hockey player who can't go unnoticed. I'd like to win another cup. I'd like to stay on the team as long as possible. It's a great organization. It's a lot of fun being a part of it. I want the fans to remember me for a long time. And that's how it's done. Thank you for the game, but do get some practice. See you next season.